Last night, you met the new Bachelor Canada. And this morning, BT exclusively hears from one of the first bachelorettes, Tim Wormel, sent home. But first, Brad Smith talks to the cast of This Is Where I Leave You.
I imagine by now you are well into the excessive facial hair phase of your depression.
It's not a good time, Wendy.
I guess it wasn't hard for you guys to dip into the platitudes of playing brother and sister when you guys have great chemistry off camera.
Felt pretty easy. Again, I feel like we have a lot of friends in common, you know?
Kind of know what you're dealing with, so you just kind of, you start on date four.
There's no working period.
No.
There's no
warm-up. What was it like working with Jane Fonda?
She classed up the joint, for sure.
Mom, close that rope.
Just breath, Judd.
We made sure that we had all of our lines memorized and we knew what each scene was about before you start working with her. She got a couple of Oscars.
But for the next 7 days, you are all my children again. And you are all grounded.
This Is Where I Leave You had its world premiere at the Toronto International Film Festival 2 weeks ago. It hits theaters today.
Canada, meet your bachelor.
Last night, Canada's newest bachelor, Tim Wormel, met his maybe match times 25. At the end of the two-hour special, Tim had to choose which 10 bachelorettes to send home, and they included the winner of Canada's Choice Contest, Rayleigh. Our Jill Bellens sat down with the 26-year-old gymnast in Calgary for a BT exclusive interview about her chance at love with Tim.
Okay, Rayleigh, so you didn't find love on The Bachelor Canada, but what was your takeaway experience?
I was happy that I got the chance to be there and got the chance to meet him. He's a great guy, just not my guy. I mean, I only wish that I got more time with him because it's so short and there's so many girls that are there that are all fighting to get time with him.
Do you believe that you can find love on The Bachelor Canada?
Oh, I believe you can find love anywhere.
Charmed beauty Rose McGowan is using her star power to raise awareness and funds for the Canadian Pulmonary Fibrosis Foundation. She told our Brad Smith why the cause is near and dear to her heart.
It's a disease where it's about scarring of the lungs. Every time you breathe, you can't, essentially. Imagine like that's happening to you and your lips turn blue. And that's what happened to my father. It's very confusing to see somebody who's like this strong man just kind of brought to their knees. It's Pulmonary Fibrosis Awareness Month in Canada, so go Canada, cpff.ca. There are these videos that are up right now on the website, and every time you retweet it with the hashtag KissIPFGoodbye, $5 gets donated.
An all-Canadian star-studded lineup hitting the stage in Winnipeg this weekend for the opening of a brand new museum. BT Winnipeg's Jeremy John has your preview.
Winnipeg is getting ready to celebrate the opening of the Canadian Museum for Human Rights. They're kicking things off with a concert called Rights Fest. It's a special concert designed to represent all Canadians. Artists like Marie-Pierre Arthur will represent our Francophone roots, while Aboriginal acts include veteran performer Buffy St. Marie. Plus, legendary singer-songwriter and humanitarian Bruce Coburn brings a legacy of hits to this very special show. You can be part of this historic event. You can actually see it Saturday night right here on City. And of course, Entertainment City will take you backstage to talk to all the stars. In Winnipeg, waiting for the opening of the Canadian Museum for Human Rights, I'm Jeremy John.
Thank you, JJ. Look for that full concert recap on Entertainment City Monday. Plus, sound off on your first taste of Tim Wormel's as The Bachelor Canada by tweeting us at NCity.